حديث الثامن حديث نمبر 8 عن عمرو بن يحيى المازني عن أبيه قال شهدت عمرو بن أبي الحسن سأل عبد الله بن زيد عن وضوء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فدعا بتور من ماء فتوضأ لهم وضوء رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأكفى على يديه من التور فغسل يديه ثلاثا ثم أدخل يده في التور فمضمض واستنشق واستنثر ثلاثا بثلاث غرفات ثم أدخل يده في التور فغسل وجهه ثلاثا ثم أدخل يده في التور فغسلهما مرتين إلى المرفقين ثم أدخل يده ثم أدخل يديه فمسح بهما رأسه فأقبل بهما وأدبر مرة واحدة ثم غسل رجليه إلى الكعبين. عمرو بن يحيى المازني narrated from his father Yahya. The hadith first of all is narrated by Bukhari in Kitab al-Wudu, Muslim Kitab al-Tahara. Bukhari, the second narration, Bukhari narrated it in Kitab al-Wudu, and also Muslim in Kitab al-Wudu. The third narration, Bukhari narrated in Kitab al-Wudu. Who is the narrator of the hadith? The first one is Amr ibn Yahya, sah? Al-Mazini. His name is Amr ibn Yahya ibn Bint. Huwa ibn Binti Abdullah ibn Zayd ibn Asim. His granddad, from his mom's side, is Abdullah ibn Zayd, the companion who's going to tell the story, the hadith. Abdullah ibn Zayd, who we're going to take. This is his grandson from his what? From his mom's side. Good. Waliduhu, his father's name is An Abihi. His father's name is who? His father's name is Yahya ibn Ammara ibn Abi al-Hasan al-Ansari al-Tabi'i. He was a Tabi'i. Thiqatun. And was given thiqa by Nasa'i rahimahullah. And the six books of hadith have narrated from him. Him and his son, Amr ibn Yahya. Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini and Yahya ibn Ammara, both of them, the father and the son, the Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, Nasa'i, all narrated from them. Amr ibn Abi Hasan. Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan is who? Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan is the uncle of Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini. Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini, his father's brother is Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, who asked Abdullah ibn Zayd. Abdullah ibn Zayd is his granddad from his mom's side. Good. Abdullah ibn Zayd, who is he? Huwa ibn Asim al-Mazini al-Ansari. Wa ummuhu, his mother is Ummu Ammara. Lahu wa li abawayhi suhba. Abdullah ibn Zayd, he was a companion and his two children were companions. وهو غير عبد الله بن زيد, and he is not Abdullah ibn Zayd ibn Abd Rabbi. Many people confuse the two. Which? Who saw the adhan? And Abdullah ibn Zayd, that we know, that brought the issue of the adhan to the Prophet. Remember, who brought the dream? So Abdullah ibn Zayd, not this one. This is another Abdullah ibn Zayd. شهد غزوة أحد. He participated in the battle of Uhud. وما بعدها, and anything after that. The six books of hadith have narrated his narration. Abdullah ibn Zayd and Amr ibn Yahya's father, who is who? Yahya ibn Ammara. Yahya ibn Ammara said, Shahidtu, I participated. Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, I participated in Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, which is his cousin, which is his brother, Sa'ala, asking Abdullah ibn Zayd. Asking who? Abdullah ibn Zayd. Fawa, wudu'i al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So here look, wu, and not wa. Meaning the action of the Prophet, how the Prophet done the wudu. So he asked him about the Prophet's wudu. How was the Prophet's wudu? Fada'a, he called for, bitawrin min ma'in. He called for a tawr. A tawr is a utensil that is made out of skin. Naam. He called for it. Fatawadda'a, he done ablution. Lahum, for them, wudu'a Rasulillah, the ablution of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَأَكْفَأَ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ فَأَكْفَأَ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ فَأَكْفَأَ means what? فأكفأ means أي مال. Again, the same thing. فأفرغ. He pushed the vessel aside like that. He pulled it. Again, look at him and Uthman, how they do the wudu. Same. Same. He pushed it aside. فغسل يديه ثلاثا. He washed his hand 3 times. He was asked. As soon as he was asked, he called for a tawr, a vessel which is made of skin. He said, bring it to me. They brought it from, water's in it. He pushed it aside. He done wudu. فأكفى على يديه. He poured it over his hand 3 times. Washed it 3 times. ثم أدخل يده. Then he put his hand into the what? The tawr. Remember, they weren't sleeping before they even done it. فمضمض واستنشق واستنثر. He took the water, put it in his mouth. هيا. And he put it to where? To his nose. And he brought it out. بثلاث غرفات. With how many takes in? How many takes in did he do it with? 3 غرفات. 3. All of the time, the both of the mouth are together. So he went 1, 2, and 3. ثلاث غرفات. ثلاث غرفات. ثم أدخل يده في التور. And then he entered his hand into the tour again. فغسل وجهه ثلاثا. He washed his face 3 times. ثم أدخل يده. And then he put his hand again into the tour, the vessel. فغسل مرتين. He washed 2 times إلى المرفقين. To what? To إلى المرفقين means what? مع, with. We took the word إلى means مع. As Allah said in the ayah, وَلَا تَأْخُذُوا أَمْوَالَهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. صح؟ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ. مع قوتكم. مع. The word إلى comes in the Arabic language as مع, with. Meaning the مرفقين is part of it. ثُمَّ يَدْخَلَ. Then he entered يَدَهُ his hand. فَمَسَحَ بِهِ مَا رَأْسَهُ. He wiped it over his head. Now it says he wiped. So the مرفقين, how many times? Twice. Umar did, Uthman did it how many times? 3 times. Pay attention. How did he wipe his over his head? ثُمَّ أَدْخَلَ يَدَهُ. ثُمَّ أَدْخَلَ يَدَيْهِ. This is different now. Now Abdullah ibn Zayd, his companion, he put both of his hand into the plate or the vessel. يَدَيْهِ, both of them. Why did he do that for? فَمَسَحَ بِهِمَا رَأْسَهُ. He took both of the hands and put it in, brought it out, and he wiped his hand with both of his hands. فأقبل. He came forward. وأدبر مرة واحدة once. ثم غسل. And he washed رجليه, his 2 feet, foot. إلى الكعبين, to his, مع كعبين. The إلى is with, like the word مع, with his heels, with his ankles, with his ankles. He did that. The fiqh of the hadith. Hirsu al-Sahaba. Brothers, the striving of the Sahabas in learning how to follow the messenger in a matter in which he did, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ala ma'rifati sunnati rasulillah. They wanted to understand and learn the Prophet's sunnah. Liyata'assu biha. So they can follow him in it. That was their intent. Did the Prophet do it? Yes. How did he do it? So they came to people and they asked, can you do it for us? Show us how the Prophet did it. 2. جواز الوضوء من آنية النحاس. The permissibility of doing wudu from a vessel that is made out of skin.
عن عمر ابن يحيى المازني عن أبيه قال شهدت عمر ابن أبي الحسن سأل عبد الله بن زيد عن وضوء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فدعا بتور من ماء فتوضأ لهم وضوء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأكفى على يديه من التور فغسل يديه 3 ثم أدخل يده في التور فمضمض واستنشق واستنثر 3 بثلاث غرفات ثم أدخل يده في التور فغسل وجهه ثلاثا ثم أدخل يديه فغسلهما مرتين إلى المرفقين ثم أدخل يده فمسح بهما رأسه فأقبل بهما وأدبر مرة واحدة ثم غسل رجليه وفي رواية بدأ بمقدم رأسه حتى ذهب بهما إلى قفاه ثم ردهما حتى رجع إلى المكان الذي بدأ منه وفي رواية أتانا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فأخرجنا له ماء في تور من صفر متفق عليه عمرو بن يحيى المازني He said, I heard from the messenger, he said, I heard from my father, sorry. And Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini from my father. He said, my father, Shahidtu, that his father said, I witnessed Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, who asked Abdullah ibn Zayd, who is this Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini? Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini, huwa ibn Binti Abdullah ibn Zayd ibn Asim. Amr ibn Yahya is the grandson. So he's the son of the daughter of Abdullah ibn Zayd. The companion who narrates who's going to do the wudu, Abdullah ibn Zayd, his daughter gave birth to Amr ibn Yahya. So he's his granddad, right? It's his granddad. Abdullah ibn Zayd is the grandfather of who? Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini. Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini, pay attention, he is his grandfather from his mom's side. Are we all clear on that? He's also a tabi'i. He is thiqa, reliable in his hadith, very strong. The six books, Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, An-Nasa'i, the six books, they narrated from him. I mean, they narrated him. And this is a reliable in his hadith. It's a thiqatul thabt. Tuwfiya, he died the year sanata 40 wa mi'ah. 140 hijriya, he died. Tuwfiya sana 40 wa mi'ah. 140, he passed away. He said, from my father. Who is his father? His father is Yahya ibn Ammara. Yahya ibn Ammara is the father of Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini. That's his father. Okay, he is an Ansari. His father is an Ansari, Tabi'i. Also a Tabi'i. وَثَقَهُ النَّسَائِيُّ Nasa'iyu considered him thiqa. And the six books of hadith have also narrated him. And Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, who's the uncle of Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini, who is the uncle of Amr Ibn Yahya al-Mazini. His uncle is called Amr ibn Abi Hassan, who is a Sahabi, who is a companion, who said, who asked Abdullah ibn Zaydin. He asked Abdullah ibn Zayd, wudu Nabi. He asked the Prophet ﷺ's wudu, ablution. He asked him the ablution of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Fada'a Abdullah ibn Zayd asked and called for if he can be brought a pot which contains water. He asked for it, min ma'in. Fatawadda'a lahum. And he done an ablution for them. Wudu'a Rasulillah, the wudu of the messenger. Pay attention. The wow. If it has a dhamma on it, huh? If it has a dhamma on it, it is the... If it has a wudu on on the waw and it's not wudu, it means the action. It means the action, wudu. But if we say wudu, it's the vessel or whatever he's been used, what's been used. So he done for them the ablution of the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَأَكْفَ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ التَّوْرِ He poured water onto his hand from the pot. فَغَسَلَ يَدَيْهِ ثَلَاثًا And he washed his hand how many times? Three times. After he had washed his hand three times, again, it is highly recommended that the person washes their hand before they put it into the utensil, regardless of whether the person was awake or asleep, doesn't matter. If they wake up, we said it's obligation. It's an obligatory act for you to wash your hands first. You're not allowed to. That's if you've woken up from a sleep, then you have to wash your hands. That's obligatory. But if it is a normal day where you were awake and you didn't go to sleep, then it's also highly recommended that you wash your hands before you put it into the pot or the vessel or the utensil you're using. فَغَسَلَ he washed يَدَيْهِ ثَلَاثًا three times he washed it. ثم after he had washed it three times, أَدْخَلَ يَدَهُ he put his hand into the pot في التوري. فَمَضْمَضَ he took that water and he then مَضْمَضَ. مَضْمَضَ means what? When you put the water into your mouth and you wobble the water in your mouth. وَاسْتَنْشَقَ that same handful you've put into your mouth, you also put into your nose. The same handful. So part of it goes into your mouth. A lot of the water will go into your mouth. You're going to leave a little bit left on your hand for it to go to your nose. Then what happens? وَاسْتَنْثَرَ the istinthar means what? That you lose your left hand and you bring out what is in your nose. Remember, what comes out of your mouth and what comes out of your nose, both of them come out at the same time. So you put it in the same time and you take it both out at the same time. بِثَلَاثِ غُرَفَاتِ three times. With one time, all of them, but hand one fist. One time like that. One, two, and three. ثُمَّ after that, أَدْخَلَ يَدَهُ he put his hand into فِي التَّوْرِ second time. He put his hand down into the pot again. فَغَسَلَ وَجْهَ he washed his what? He washed his face. In our previous, we took what a face is. The face is from your ear. That is in terms of its width and its height. We said from the person's chin to the person's where the hair starts from. That is your face. All of that has to be washed. It makes it easier if you do it sideways. If you take the water, or if you start the water with the top, and you put it on your head and it rolls down, the water goes down, and you wash your face with it as it goes down. It's easier. Some people tend to like to do it from the side, and it allows them to wash their face better. As the water rolls down, you're able to make it reach every part of your face. ثم أدخل يده then he put his hand after he washed his face three times. Washed it three times. ثم after that he أدخل يده he put his hand into the what? في التوري he put it into the pot. فغسلهما مرتين إلى المرفقين how many times did he wash his up to his? He washed it three times up to his elbows. Two times. فغسلهما he washed it مرتين twice. إلى المرفقين. We took before that the word إلى it means مع. The word إلى comes as the word with مع. And we mentioned that in the hadith of عثمان رضي الله تعالى عنه. ثم أدخل and then after he washed it twice up to where? Up to his elbows. So the elbows they go into it. ثم أدخل يدي then he washed his hands. So he put his hands into the pot again. فَمَسَّحَ بِهِمَا رَأْسَ he wiped on his what? His head. Now this hadith, remember, if you bring this hadith with the hadith of Uthman, what would you find out? A lot of things. So that's what you should do, bringing all the narrations together. Bringing all the narrations together allows you to what? To see what's missing from each part and what additional information has been added to this sahabi added to it and this whatnot. That's the benefit of collected hadiths. And that's the benefit of actually knowing a lot of narrations. That is what allows a person to be a faqih. By gathering all the narrations, looking at the slight differences.
Just restart. Start that. Just press it.
By bringing all the narrations together, Once you've brought all the narrations together, you will be able to know what information is additionally added to this narration over this narration. And what's missing from this narration and what is additional to this narration. And then after that, it'll allow you to see the matter in a wider way. So the hadith of Uthman radiallahu anhu that we took, and the hadith of Abdullah ibn Zayd, the two wudu, you can see what's missing, what's not in there and what's in here. Here what you see is what? That فَأَقْبَلَ بِهِمَا وَأَدْبَرَ مَرَّةً وَاحِدًا. We now find out that wasn't in the hadith of Uthman, it was what? First of all, the hadith of Uthman didn't mention how to wipe on your hair. They didn't mention that. The hadith of Abdullah ibn Zayd allowed us to know, the hadith of Uthman just told us wipe over your head. But now it told us how to wipe over the head. Also, this hadith, the hadith of Abdullah ibn Zayd, has also informed us that the washing of the mirfiqain, it can be done twice. It can be done, how many? That it can be done twice. Whereas Uthman was one, it mentioned three times. It said three times. Also, this hadith, Abdullah ibn Zayd also added this part, which is ثُمَّ غَسَلَ رِجْلَيْهِ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ. The Prophet ﷺ washed his legs up to his, with the heels on it. The hadith of Uthman didn't mention that. It just said that he washed his leg. So it doesn't really tell us where did the Prophet wash it. Does that make sense? So Abdullah ibn Zayd what informs us that the washing is up to, with the ankles. Sorry, I said heels. I meant ankles. With the ankles, Abdullah ibn Zayd's narration. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ وَالْمِنَّةِ. That's what we benefit from the narration. This hadith is collected by Imam al-Bukhari, the first narration. Remember, there are how many narrations are there here? There are two more. So the first narration, Imam al-Bukhari narrated, the first one, which is the one I explained now. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated in Kitab al-Wudu, Muslim narrated in Kitab al-Tahara. There's another wording now, which is the second riwayah. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ and another wording, بَدَأَ بِمُقَدِّمِ رَأْسِهِ. The next narration is narrated by Imam Muslim, rahimahullah. In the second narration, it's narrated by Imam Muslim and Imam al-Bukhari. Both of them narrated it. Bukhari narrated Kitab al-Wudu. Muslim also narrated in this time Kitab al-Wudu. Which is what? بَدَأَ he started بِمُقَدِّمَ رَأْسِهِ. He started the beginning of his head حَتَّى ذَهَبَ بِهِمَا إِلَىٰ قَفَىٰ until he reached his what? His neck. The back of your neck. This is where qafa is called. Qafa is where the place where you can, if you hit a person from there, it's in a dangerous spot. Right there. That's the qafa. So he went back to where your hair finishes at the bottom. ثُمَّ رَدَّهُمَا and he brought it back حَتَّى رَجَعَ إِلَى الْمَكَانِ الَّذِي بَدَأَ مِنْهُ until he came back to where he started from. Whereas the first one, the first riwayah, this one, all it said is فَأَقْبَلَ بِمَا وَأَجْبَرَ مَرَّةً وَاحِدًا. He went back and went forward. But you don't know how back he went. This part of the riwayah allows you to know how far you can go back, which is to your qafa, your neck. وَفِي riwayah in another, the third riwayah now. The third riwayah, Bukhari narrated it, and Muslim did not narrate it. Bukhari narrated it, and Muslim did not narrate this last one. The third riwayah, he said, وَفِي riwayah. Muslim did not narrate this one. It's only in Bukhari. وفي رواية in another رواية أتانا رسول الله the messenger came فأخرجنا له ماء we brought out for him what ماء water في تور which was in a pot من صفر that pot was made from what نحاس which is copper was in it so this hadith is the companion, Abdullah ibn Zayd, after being asked about how the Prophet ﷺ wudu was. And I said, remember the word wudu, بِضَمِّ الْوَاوِ, when the waw is made a dhamma on it, it's the action. But when a fatha is put on it, it is the actual water itself. When he was asked to do wudu, he had taught them how to do it. The fiqh of this hadith. حِرْسُ الصَّحَابَ, the striving of the companions themselves. Which companion are we referring to? We're referring to Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan. Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan, who asked Abdullah ibn Zayd. He's a companion, but he asked another companion. He wanted to know what? The Prophet's wudu لِيَتَأَسُّوا بِهِ فِيهَا. So he can, so the Prophet's and way of wudu can be followed. So you write, you realize here that the Sahabas, that they were reliable people in how they transmitted. Each one is informing about the wudu, and you find that they're all on the same wavelength. They are all doing the same wudu of the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. Number two, jawazu, the permissibility of al wudu min aniyat al nuhas, the permissibility of using a vessel, a utensil which is out of copper. You can use it, but I didn't mention that last time. Number two is,
you said skin instead of copper last time.
The permissibility of using copper that is made out of an aniya, and that is permissible to use, and that is pure, and that it doesn't fall off under the prohibition of the impermissibility of gold and what? Silver. No, it doesn't. Number three, istihbabu, that it's liked to combine the istinshaq and the madmada. The madmada and the istinshaq should both be done with one hand. Four, washing your hands up to your mirfiqain, with the mirfiqain added to your elbows. Washing your hands up to your elbows. And the permissibility of doing it twice or three times. Five, wujubu masḥ al-ra's kullu marrat al-wahida, the obligation of wiping over your head, all of it, the whole head. Six, jawazu ghasl al-wajh, the permissibility of washing your face with one hand. With one hand. But as we know, it is better that the person uses two hands and puts two hands and washes it. It's permissible. But one hand is permissible as well. Number seven, the permissibility of asking for aid and support in somebody to bring you something, that is not haram. You can ask somebody for a favor to bring you something. Number eight, التعليم بالفعل, teaching by way of action, أبلغ, is more greater and more felt in understanding than speech. Sitting down and doing something for the people reaches a further and a greater, has a bigger impact for the people than if you were to speak it all day. Nine, jawazu, the permissibility of putting your hand in the utensil after you've washed it. After you've washed it. Jawazu idkhal al-yadi fi al-ina'i ba'da ghasliha. After you wash your hands, the permissibility of doing it, of putting it in. Number 10, ityaru al-kabiri ila atba'i, wa ibtida'uhu iyyahu bi ihdhar al-wudu'i ila 'allimu anna bihi hajatun ilayhi. The permissibility, the elder person coming to his followers, his people, and starting it for them by bringing water the elder person coming to his followers number 10. The elder person asking his followers with the presence of somebody else. So for instance, I see another person who's got knowledge, and I ask him, that person of knowledge, if he can teach other people to benefit them in a matter, and also present for him whatever he needs in order to do. And that is what happened by Abdullah ibn Zayd and Amr ibn Abi al-Hasan. Both of them are companions, both of them know the wudu. Amr ibn al-Yahya is with his own brother and his own family and his own people, his followers, his people, and he asked Abdullah ibn Zayd to do wudu for them and brought the water for him when there was a need, because there was a need there. 11. No, just 10. No, sorry, just 10. Number 11 could just be ikhtilaf al-ulama, dispute of the scholars. Number 11 could be the dispute of the scholars regarding, does the elbows add into what the hand is or not? And we said that the strongest is that yes, it's part of the hands, the elbows, and they should be washed. And we spoke about that in with the evidences in the last lesson, or the previous lesson.
Part of the arm or part of the hand?
Part of the hand. Arm, I'm sorry. It's part of the arm. That is part of the arm. But also the hand is also part of the hand, because the hand and the arm all should be washed together. So the hand and the arm are part of the elbow. So whenever you do that wudu, you have to wash your hand and the arm with the elbows. The second ikhtilaf is, and the scholars have disputed, the fuqaha, in how is the way that a person goes back and front in wiping over their hair, head. There's three madhabs in this issue, three madhahib. The first madhab is to start with the beginning, then to reach the neck, and to come back to where you started from. The second one is to start from the beginning, to reach your neck, and leaving it there. And number three is to start from the neck, to go to the front, and then go back to the neck again. And the strongest is, according to this hadith, the first one is the strongest, to start from the front, to go to the neck, and to come back to where you started from, which is the front. Where did that dispute occur from? The dispute occurred from, because the first hadith of Amr ibn Yahya al-Mazini, the first riwayah, it said, فَأَقْبَلَ بِهِمَا وَأَدْبَرَ مَرَّةً وَاحِدًا. He went forward and then he went backward, one time. So there's dispute. Where is the forward and where is the back? But the other riwayah clarifies where it says, بَدَأَ بِمُقَدَّمِ رَأْسِهِ. He started with the beginning of his head, حَتَّى دَابَ بِهِمَا إِلَى قَفَاهُ, until he went to his neck, ثُمَّ رَدَّهُمَا, until he brought it back, both of them, إِلَى الْمَكَانِ الَّذِي بَدَأَ مِنْهُ, from the place in which he started from.